And this is very tough. This is real talk, people. Today could be your day of salvation. Today could be your day of salvation. A lot of people walking around saying, I don't need Jesus. Why do I need Jesus? What can he do for me? I have everything I need. I have a car. I got money. I got a house. I got a nice wife. Or I got a nice husband. Or whatever. I got beautiful kids. I have a house with a wife taking pants, so to speak. Reason. But guess what? All of those things are not what you need. So you can't take nothing with you when Jesus comes. Have you ever seen a horse attached to a U-Haul? I don't think so. When you die, you just go. And you only thing you have is your soul. And your soul goes straight to God. God says, from death to good, to death to shall be first. But your soul belongs to me, saith the Lord. Amen. And if your soul is not prepared for Jesus when he comes, you are going to be condemned and sent to the abyss. So let the fire which God has prepared for Satan and his minions, the lake of fire. Amen. There's a difference between hell and the lake of fire. Hell is forsaken right now. And he's free to roam around. He's the ruler of this world right now. Amen. Amen. He's the prince of the air right now. Amen. Scripture says, Satan rolls around, walks around like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. And he comes to kill, steal, and destroy. And that's all he wants to do is kill your flesh up. He wants to tear up your flesh day to day to make sure that you don't know Jesus. To make sure that you don't even come close to Jesus. He's going to make you do his best because he knows his time is short. He knows where he's going. His final destination is the lake of fire. Amen. You know what he knows these things. Even Jesus even Satan believes that Jesus exists. But guess what? The demons must have come and fear at that name, Jesus. So if it's different than believing and acting on your belief, I believe I might get a raise today. Guess this? I might get a raise today. But I just believe it. But when I act on that belief by doing a better job and doing my best, and then the boss calls me to the office and says, I'm giving you a raise. You've exceeded and went beyond the call of duty in your position. You got to act on your belief. Amen. A lot of people believe, but you got to act on your belief. You got to act out your salvation. You got to have faith and put all your trust in Jesus. Amen? Amen. Because no matter what you have in this world right now, your car, your house, your husband, your wife, your kids, your bank account, your credit card, it's all temporary. It's all temporary. Even your life is temporary. But Jesus is permanent. Jesus is permanent. And he's going to be waiting for you to come to him on judgment day. He's going to be waiting for you. You know what Scripture says? Scripture says, many will be running to and fro. Many will be idle and cold, and there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Don't be on the run. Because you know what Jesus is going to say to those that are weeping and gnashing of teeth and running from Jesus? He's going to say, depart from me, I never knew you. Those are the worst words that you ever want to hear in your life and in your afterlife. That is not going to be a good day for you. Consider that your last day on this planet. And that's if you make it through God's wrath. That's if you make it through the wrath of God. Because when God's wrath comes down to pour out, you'll be destroyed. And those that have accepted Jesus as their personal Savior will be with Him for millennia and the new generation. Can you go with something like that? The new Jerusalem. Amen. Not a millennium, 1,000 years. Whatever that word is for, 1,000 years, we will be with Jesus. And you will be judging angels and judging humans. Amen. Amen. And Satan will be let loose on the earth. For the Bible says, woe to those that are on the earth during those times. For the beast will be set free. Amen. And God's wrath will be pouring upon the earth. And the Holy Spirit, Scripture says, the Holy Spirit will be caught the earth. When the world is evangelized, and the church is complete, the Holy Spirit is leaving the earth. And that's what all hell is going to break loose. When the Holy Spirit is caught, all hell is going to break loose. There's going to be no time for anyone to seek Jesus, to be with Jesus. That's going to be it for us. Because we already made our decision to walk in the darkness, to follow the darkness. But every choice you make in this world has consequences. Every choice you make has consequences. And our God is a righteous God. A righteous God. He's not going to let anything untrue or wicked enter the kingdom of heaven. And it's only through the blood of Jesus that you can be right clean. Am I right about it? Jesus said, I will take your sins and cast them into the depths of the sea, and I will remember them no more. It doesn't matter what you've done. It doesn't matter what you're doing. And it doesn't matter what you're going to do. Jesus will forgive you and let you clean with His blood. And it's only through the blood, the blood, the blood, the blood of Jesus that you can be made clean and be made new. The old is old and the new is new. You are a new creation in Christ. And you are such a man, the Lord and Savior. If you declare with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, and you believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you will be saved. It doesn't say you might be saved. It doesn't say I will think about it. It says you will be saved. Amen. That's God's word. You will be saved. That's all it takes. But see, the problem here is, a lot of people, they want to be saved, right? They want eternal life, right? They want Jesus to give them everything and all of these things.
What would they do?